Ringo Starr, it's been suggested that boys coming from the particular area that you come from, if you hadn't found an interest in music, might have found it much more difficult to get out and make a go of life. Would you comment on this?
I think it's true, you know. I mean, when I was 16 and that, you know, I used to walk on the road, you know, with the rest of the lads, and we'd have all our drape coats on and just, you know, we've had a few knocks and that with other rival gangs sort of thing. But then I got the drums and the bloke next door played a guitar and I got a job.
Teddy boy!
And we started playing together, and another bloke in work made a bass out of an old tea chest, you know, in them days. This was about 58, mind you. And we played together, and then we started playing on dances and things, you know, and we took an interest in it. And we stopped going, you know, out of sort of hanging around corners every night.
Would you say that the enormous difference which your success in this field has greatly influenced you, Ringo, as far as your philosophy of life or what you want to get out of it?
Oh, yeah.
George Harrison, how different is your life now as a member of the Beatles to what it was, say, even 4 years ago?
Everything's completely changed. We don't have a private life anymore, and we are public property now. Not that we mind.
You don't mind being such very public property with no private time at all?
Well, you get accustomed to it, and, you know, after a while, it's just, you just take it for granted, and you just do everything automatically, like signing autographs and waving at people.
What about home life with your own family? Do you ever get any these days?
Yeah, occasionally. Say once every fortnight, we manage to get home. And, If we're not appearing in our hometown, then it's usually okay. They don't expect us to be there, and it's, you know, quite quiet.
But has changed your status with the family much?
Not really. It makes them more popular, and people sort of, after a while, spot my parents anyway. You know, they're like, or the same with the others. You know, they'll say there's George's dad, or, well, as before, they wouldn't know him from Adam. But, you know, they're just still the same as before.
What about the wealth that comes with this kind of success? Has that made a great deal of difference to the way you live and the way your family live?
No, it hasn't made, not so far, it hasn't made any difference, except for holidays and things like that. You know, we can just get the money out of the bank and go wherever we want.
And you're one of the reputed deep thinkers of this group. How do you see it as a peak in your life? What happens to you after this is over?
Well, I suppose we'll stay doing this sort of stuff for a couple of years. Naturally, we won't be able to stay at this level, but we should have another 2 years at least, I think.
Then what happens to George Harrison then?
I don't know. I'll know by the time that comes along. Probably have a little business or something like that.
You don't want to go on in the profession?
Probably, yeah. I'd like to make records, you know, with other artists. I don't mean perform, I mean as a producer.
The technical
thing. But I don't know. You can't really tell at this stage.
Paul McCartney, you're one of the original Beatles. Where did the name Beatles originate?
Well, Dibbs. John thought of it, first of all, just as a name, just for a group, you know. We just didn't have any name. Well, yeah, we did have a name, but we had about 10 of them a week, you know. We didn't like this idea, so we had to settle on one particular name. And John came up with the name Beatles one night. And he sort of explained how it was spelt with an EA, and we said, oh, yes, it's a joke.
Since when it's come to represent a large section of the young population in England called the Beatle people. Do people regard yourself as leaders of this particular group?
No, we're not leaders of any sort of a group. The thing is, people always say, you started great trends and things, but in actual fact, all that we've done is gone along with the trends, and if in going along with it, we sort of encouraged other people to go along with a couple of our ideas, you know. All very well, but we haven't tried consciously to start anything like a trend, you know.
You're very much younger when this enormous success started, and you're riding the summit of it now. Do you see it as a peak, a mountain, interfering with the flow of your life?
I don't really know what you mean by very much younger. It was only a year ago.
But you've been working since 58, haven't you?
Well, yeah, not working, you know. I mean, strictly speaking, we've been out of work since 58, and we've been doing this as a hobby, because we've only been doing it as semi-pros. I left school and went right into it, and we were only sort of picking up a few quid a week, you know. It really wasn't work. I think the main thing is now that as we've got ourselves a bit of security, we don't really have to worry, at the moment anyway, what we're going to do after. So we don't.
None of you are really concerned with going on in the in this field as a profession.
Yeah, of course we are. I think all of us really, if it all suddenly flopped, then we would do something in this profession. But what we mean by Ringo and George's answers, what we mean that we don't really want to do, like the conventional answer is, I'd like to do ballads and films and straight acting, you know, which is so corny, because half the people who say that can't act or ballad or film, you know. So we probably wouldn't want to do that unless we thought we could do it. We're having a bash at a film next year, and if we find that any of us can act, then possibly, when it finishes, say one out of us may become actors, but we haven't got any great hopes of being actors at the moment.
It said John Lennon that you have the most goon-type humour of the four Beatles.
Who said that?
I think I read it in one of the newspaper reports.
I know, the newspapers are like...
No, what are they like?
Wrong.
This is all going wrong. I want to get a nice personality bit.
I haven't got a nice personality.
Is this evidence of goon-type humour?
No, I don't think I really have goon-type humour. That's just an expression people use.
What's the success you've enjoyed with the Beatles meant to you personally?
More money than I had before. That's the good bit.
Is it going to make any difference to your life, the way you live it after, say, this calms down, the enormous excitement you're generating at the moment?
I don't know, no, really.
Do you think a career as a comic might open up to you?
No. I don't stand a chance of being a comic.
Why not?
I'm not funny enough.
You're interested in poetry at school.
Who said?
It's printed in a book compiled by the Beatles and entitled The Beatles.
I haven't read that book. We don't normally write those things.
Written any good comic poems lately?
Yes, sir.
I just happen to have here by sheerest coincidence.
Dressed in my brown... Oh, no, I've lost it. Hold on. I can't read it here. I've only just written it. Well, that's how it starts, actually. Dressed in my teen old brown sweater, I easily micked with the crowd at Neville Club, a seamy hole. Soon, all but soon, people acoustic me saying such thing as, "We're the charge, man." I'm turning over. All too soon, I notice boys and girls sitting in a hobbled lump, smoking hernia and taking Odeon and getting very high. Some were only 4'3" high. But he had Indian hump, which he grew in his sleep. But things like that just help me keep sane.
Is this business enough to drive you insane?
No, I'm quite normal, really. If you read in the Beatle books, it says I'm quite normal.